Hello student, yes, in the last class we are going to discuss about the concept of force, right? In that we can study the concept of definition of the force. After that we define the definition for the force, then we study the types of forces. In types of forces we discuss about the contact force. After discussing with the contact force, we discuss about the non-contact force. Right? In the non-contact force, we study two types of forces. What are the two types of forces we study in the non-contact force? Means, one is magnetic force and another one is the electrostatic force. These are the two types of forces we study in the non-contact force. What are these non-contact force? The force which do not have any physical attachment between the two substances. These types of the force we call it as a non-contact force. In non-contact force, we discussed about already the two things. One is magnetic force. The force exerted by the magnet, we call it as a magnetic force. What is electrostatic force? The force that exerted by the electric field. Electrostatic field. That type of the force we call it as an electrostatic force. And the last another one, third type of the force that is present in the non-contact force. The third type of the force what we are going to discuss in the force chapter is gravitational force. What is the last type of the non-contact force? The non-contact force, the third type is the gravitational force. What is this gravitational force? Who discovered this gravitational force? Where exactly the gravitational force is present? Is that gravitational force is present in the planet of our Earth? Then who is going to explain this gravitational force? If you see, the first gravitational force was explained by Sir Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton first explained the concept of the gravitational force. What he explained? How are we going to know about this gravitational force? Take an example. How Sir Isaac Newton explained the concept of the gravitational force. When Sir Isaac Newton just sit below one tree, that apple tree, and that time one of the apple just fall from the tree. One of the apple just fall from that apple tree and it reaches the ground. Then Sir Isaac Newton think that what make this apple to fall to the ground? It can make flight in the space also, right? It can make fly in the space also. But it is not fly. It not stuck in the space. But it reaches the ground. Why it reaches the ground? What is the force that present in the earth that attracts all the molecules towards it? Then sir going to think about the sum of the force is there. Okay, sum of the force is there that attracts all the molecules towards the ground of the earth, towards the center of the earth. That force Sir Isaac Newton called as a gravitational force. What is gravitational force? After finding how we are going to get know about this gravitational force, now we are going to think, or now we are going to find the definition of the gravitational force. What is this gravitational force? What is the definition of gravitational force? If you see, the pull exerted by an object possessing mass. This is the definition of the gravitational force. What is the definition? What is the definition of the gravitational force? The pull exerted by an object possessing mass. What is the definition of the gravitational force? The definition of the gravitational force is the pull exerted by an object possessing mass. If you just read the definition, you will not get what exactly the meaning of the gravitational force. Now we are going to understand what is this exactly the definition. Consider, just take any of the subject or any of the object, okay? Take any of the object, that just take any ball, any of the object which should have the mass. Okay, you want to take the object, that object should have some of the mass. Just pull it up. What you are going to do? You are going to pull that object towards the upward direction. What happened? Due to some of the force what we put for that object, it will move for the upward direction. After that, what happened? After attending some of that time, it loses its force. And again, it come back from the up position to the ground position. That is, from the exerted state to the ground state. Why it come back from the exerted level to the ground level? Due to the presence of the mass in that object, that mass attracted by the gravitational force. That mass was attracted by the gravitational force, that's why it pulled itself towards itself. Now you understood the definition of the gravitational force. The pull exerted by an object possessing the mass, that we call it as a gravitational force. Due to the presence of the gravitational force only, we can stand here. Or we can walk, we can jump, we can run, right? Due to the presence of the gravitational force only, we can stand, we can dance, anything we can do. Imagine that if the gravitational force is not there, means we are floating in the space, right? If you just saw in the moon, no gravitational force is there, right? No gravitational force is there. That's why there any of the object will go, if any of the person will go, they float on the space. Understood? Only due to the presence of the gravitational force, we can walk, we can swim, we can jump, we can ride, everything we can do only in the presence of the gravitational force. These are the three important type of the non-contact process. What are the three important type of non-contact process we discuss it? The three important type of non-contact process we discuss it is magnetic force, electrostatic force and gravitational force. These are the three important types of the force. After discussing with the three important types of the forces, now next we move on to the next part of the chapter. What is the name of the chapter? Force and pressure. We completed with the force. Now we are going to start discussing with the pressure. I think no doubt in the force, right? In the force, we study about two types of the forces. One is the contact forces, non-contact forces. In the contact force, we discussed about muscular force and some other forces. In non-contact forces, we discussed about magnetic force, electrostatic force, and gravitational force. These all are the concepts what we discussed in the force. After that, now we are going to discuss about the pressure. What is this pressure? What we are going to discuss about this pressure? Okay, when a force acts on an object, consider that if I am giving some of the force, okay, I am going to give some of the force to my palm, means therefore some of the pressure is takes place in this palm. I take this example. I am taking one of the example, right? Okay, I am taking this two chalk piece. Okay, if I am going to give some of the force to this chalk piece and I will hit this chalk piece. Okay, I am going to take this chalk piece and I am going to hit this chalk piece to this chalk piece. What happens? Some of the pressure is exerted between these two chalk. Understood? This is how we can tell the definition for the pressure. What is pressure? When a force, when any of the force that acts on an object, then we call it that the pressure is done. Okay, take some of the examples. Now we will see some of the examples. You are going to lift some of the object, means what you are going to do? You are going to apply some of the force to that object and you are going to lift that object, right? In that time also the pressure happens. When you are going to apply that force, the pressure between the hand and that object happens. That is also an example for the pressure. And what is the formula to find the pressure? Means the formula to find the pressure is force by area. What is the formula to find the pressure? The formula to find the pressure is force by area. And what is the SI unit for that? This is very important, okay? They may ask, what is the SI unit of the pressure? The SI unit of the pressure is Pascal. What is the SI unit of the pressure? The SI unit of the pressure is Pascal. And what is the formula to find the pressure? The formula to find the pressure is force by area. And what is the definition of the pressure? If you see, what is the definition of the pressure is, when a force acts on an object, some of the pressure which created, that we call it as a pressure. Understood the definition? Okay, then we completed with the non-contact forces, definition of pressure, and also the SI unit of the pressure. After discussing with the SI unit of the pressure, or after discussing with the definition of the pressure, now we are going to do one of the problem. Okay, now I am going to tell one problem to you. Just write down the problem and we are going to solve the problem. Okay, take the problem. Take the first question. A force of 100 N, a force of 100 Newton is applied to an object of area 2 meter square. Full stop. Calculate the pressure. One more time, I just read the question. A force of 100 Newton is applied to an object of area 2 meter square. Full stop. Calculate the pressure. Okay, now we are going to calculate the pressure. You know the formula, right? What is the formula to find the pressure? The formula to find the pressure is force by area. In the question, they given that the force of 100 Newton. Therefore, F is equals to 100. What is the force they given? They given the force. F is equals to 100 Newton. And what is the area they given in the question? area is equals to 2 meter square. Therefore, A is equals to 2 meter square. Just substitute the value for the, just substitute the values to the formula. Therefore, the pressure is equals to 100 by 2. 2 ones are 250. Therefore, the pressure act by that substance is equals to 250 Pascal. After writing the answer, we want to write the SI unit also. What is the amount you will get for that question? The question, they given the force is equals to 100 and the area is equals to 2. 2 ones are 2 fives are 0, 50. Therefore, the pressure exerted by the object is 50 Pascal. This is how we are going to solve the problem related with the pressure. What is the formula to find the pressure? What is the formula to find the pressure? Pressure is equals to force by area. What is the formula to find the pressure? Pressure is equals to force by area. And what is the SI unit? The SI unit of the pressure is Pascal. Understood? After discussing with the pressure and what is the formula to find the pressure, now we are going to discuss about the pressure exerted by the liquid. Okay, now we are going to study about, is that pressure exerted by the liquid? Liquid also exerts some of the pressure? Yes. All substances or all objects always exhibit some of the pressure. Now, first we are going to discuss about the liquid. After that, we will start discussing with the gas. Okay. What is the heading? The pressure exerted by liquid. How we are going to know that is that pressure is exerted by the liquid? Okay. For that, we want to do so many activities. Okay. Some of the activities I will explain and some of the activities I will show the video to understand better. First, we want to take first activity. We want to take liquid. Okay. We want to take the water in a container tube. What we are going to do? We are going to take a water in a container tube. Okay, we take the water. Then what we are going to check in that? We want to check that is that pressure is increases with the depth of the water or the pressure is decreases with the depth of the water. Just make two holes in the last of the container tube. Just make two holes in the last of the container tube. When you are going to make the holes, what happens? The water that present in the container tube is ready to come out like a fountain, right? It is ready to come out like a fountain with the large amount of the force. This activity tells us that the pressure increases with increasing depth. If in the increasing of the depth, always the pressure is more. This is the point we want to learn when for the pressure increases with increasing the depth. And also I said that so other activities we will see in the video. And another next one point you want to know in this concept is a liquid exerts the pressure on the wall of its container also. That's right, right? When the container tube, some of the liquid show its pressure to the wall of the container only also. That's why it is hurry to go out from the surface of the container. Right? Therefore, the two important points what you are going to study in this concept. One is a pressure increases with increasing depth and the another one is a liquid exerts the pressure on the wall of its container. To explain these two properties, I said that I am going to show the video to you to understand properly the two properties. I think you understand what are the concepts we discussed today. Okay then, thank you guys, and we will see in the next class, we will discuss about the pressure exerted by the gas. Okay, thank you.